quite a number of corporate stories at the end of the month. The Competition Commission clears the joint acquisition of Coca-Cola Beverages Philippines by Aboitiz Equity Ventures and Coca-Cola Euro-Pacific Partners. The two entities secured on Tuesday the antitrust body's approval for the full ownership of Coca-Cola Beverages at $1.8 billion. Parties expect to close the transaction by the end of February upon completion of remaining conditions. Meanwhile, PLDT is investing 2.1 billion pesos in the Meralco-owned Radius Telecoms. The telco giant is subscribing to nearly 2.5 million common shares of Radius, priced at 850 pesos apiece. The undertaking brings to 34.9% PLDT's stake in the company. PLDT says the move will solidify its market position and increase its market share by capitalizing on the fiber facilities of Radius. The utilities now, a unit of Manila Water, inks a 10-year deal with Cebu for the supply and delivery of potable surface water in the province. Manila Water Philippine Ventures also confirms it's seeking to revive an 8 billion peso concession deal with Pangasinan. The agreement was terminated in December due to the non-fulfillment of conditions by the provincial government. As for Prime Infra, its waste management unit inaugurated this week its automated materials recovery facility in Cebu. Prime Integrated Waste Solutions says the facility is the first in the country to use state-of-the-art equipment for segregating and storing waste. Finally, Rockwell Land secures a 5 billion peso loan from Metrobank. The Lopez's Real Estate DevCo is using the loan to fund its capex, land acquisitions, and other investments.
The International Monetary Fund raises its 2024 growth forecast for the world economy. The IMF now pegs it at 3.1%. That's 0.2 percentage points higher than its previous forecast in October. It cites unexpected resilience in major advanced and emerging market economies around the world for the adjustment. The United States and China, the world's two largest economies, both saw significant upgrades to their growth outlook. The U.S. economy expected now to grow by 2.1%, while China's economy is on track to hit 4.6%. Despite this, the IMF predicts global growth will remain below its recent historical average of 3.8% this year and next. This is due to continued impacts of elevated interest rates, the withdrawal of pandemic-related government support, and persistently low levels of productivity. Philippine economic growth in 2023 falling short of the government's target. The country's full-year GDP print came in at 5.6%, which is below government's 6-7% goal. This is also slower than the 7.6% growth seen in 2022. The industries which contributed the most to the annual growth were wholesale and retail trade, repair of motor vehicles and motorcycles, financial and insurance activities, and construction. NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan notes, while the growth figure missed government's target, it still makes the country the second fastest among major emerging economies in Asia, next to Vietnam.
We welcome the robust growth in spending for restaurants and hotels, transport and recreation, reflecting the improvements in the labor market and steady growth in remittances. Nothing less than massive, sustained investment is needed to achieve high-quality job-creating growth and inclusion. Thus, a major effort will be made to address critical factors affecting investment decisions. We shall improve the ease of doing business through digitalization and continuous streamlining of policies and regulations, accelerate the execution of game-changing public infrastructure projects to ensure we have the fiscal resources to implement the above-mentioned strategies. The government will streamline, digitalize, and enhance our tax administration systems by implementing the Ease of Paying Taxes Act. At the same time, we'll work with legislators to enact new revenue-generating measures to build a solid fiscal foundation.
Asian markets trading mixed, mirroring Wall Street's overnight performance. This comes after the world's second largest economy, China, saw its manufacturing activity contracting for the fourth straight month in January. Beijing Statistics Bureau said the official Purchasing Managers Index rose to 49.2% in January. Now that figure is actually higher than December's 49, but it was still below the 50 mark separating growth from contraction. The mixed market movement in Asia also comes as investors brace for the Fed's first rate decision for the year. Taking a look at the board now, China markets mixed as investors assess Beijing's latest factory data. Australia's ASX 200 meanwhile closed at 76.8 or 80, surpassing the record high set back in August of 2021. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. They are pointing to a muted open ahead of the U.S. Fed's policy decision. Investors in the region also bracing for inflation figures from Germany, the bloc's biggest economy. Stateside now, futures for the tech-heavy Nasdaq and the S&P 500 are down following the earnings results from mega-cap stocks Microsoft and Alphabet. Alphabet's ad revenue came in below expectations, while Microsoft's cloud growth disappointed.
The Philippines, among the chosen few by America to be its partner in diversifying its semiconductor supply chain under the CHIPS and Science Act. This is according to visiting U.S. Undersecretary for Economic Growth, Energy and the Environment, Jose Fernandez. The other countries that will receive funding from the U.S. government to make the ecosystem of their local semiconductor industry more conducive to investors are Vietnam, Panama, Puerto Rico, and Mexico. The U.S. government has earmarked $500 million for the International Technology, Security, and Innovation Fund. Electronics and semiconductor products are among the Philippines' top merchandise exports, and the industry generates up to 2.5 million jobs. Green Hills Shopping Center in San Juan City has been included in the U.S. Trade Representative's review of notorious markets for counterfeiting and piracy. The notorious markets list highlights online and physical markets that reportedly engage in or facilitate substantial trademark counterfeiting or copyright piracy. The report said the U.S. government has worked with stakeholders to enforce the law against counterfeit sellers, including product seizures and legal charges. It added the mall management is in the process of converting the Fame Shopping Center into a high-end mall with legitimate sellers. ABS-CBN has reached out for a comment to the management of the Green Hills Shopping Center.